how they are, the accomplishments of their children, and I hope they enjoy the morning. I thank them for being here. The program will proceed in three parts. First part will be the distribution of awards. We have the presenters here who will be distributing 10 awards to our seniors. Then we will go through recognition of awards, where I will simply acknowledge the student receiving the award and have them stand at their place today. And then there are 14 of those, and the bulk of the program revolves around the third part, which are the scholarships, and there are 52 scholarships that we will be distributing. So we have a lot of things to do, and I will do my best to keep the program moving forward. But I want you to have a sense of how we will proceed.
The Stoll Medallion is awarded by the Board of Education to the senior who ranks highest in the scholarship as determined by her cumulative academic average. Our valedictorian is Joel Kuzak. The Silver Medallion is also awarded by the Board of Education to the senior who ranks second highest in scholarship as determined by his cumulative academic average. And our salutatorian is Yasek Basket.
The Youth Civic Awards were to be distributed by Mayor Walter Bergacki, who also unfortunately had a matter he had to attend to of a business nature this morning and just could not be here. That's highly unusual, so it had to be very important. To represent Mayor Bergacki, we have Councilwoman Mrs. Elizabeth Calabrese.
Good morning, everyone. And on behalf of the mayor and council, I too would like to congratulate the class of 2004 and wish them the very best in their future. These plaques are awarded by the mayor and the governing body of the borough of Wellington to a boy and a girl of each graduating class who, through their leadership qualities, sense of responsibility, and conscientious effort, have contributed outstanding service to their school and their community. Our first recipient is Holly Blaine. Our second recipient, Edward O'Shea.
These gentlemen will also handle our next three awards following, because the Sergeant Elijah Valamont could not be here this morning, so I asked the veterans to handle the military awards for us.
Good morning, and congratulations to the senior class on that graduation. These prizes are awarded to two students who have demonstrated outstanding leadership in the classroom and school activities and who successfully hold school offices or positions of responsibility. The prize consists of certificates and savings bonds. I would like to call Michelle Bednarz. Alicia Lama. And I would like to introduce our VFW chaplain, Stan Siren.
This is a United States Marine Corps Distinguished Flag Award. This award is presented to a senior who has set an example to the underclassmen by exhibiting a high level of citizenship, leadership, and voice, and has participated in our co-curricular program. Danielle Liberato.
Before I present the award, I'd just like to say that I've been honored over the past 40 years to participate in these ceremonies on occasion. And I just noticed that each year those steps are getting longer and steeper. I'm pleased to be able to present this award to a student who has participated in the music program and is given in recognition of musical excellence and outstanding citizenship. Todd Bisdom. As an old drummer, congratulations.
The Scholastic Excellence Award is presented to a student who displays hard work, enthusiasm, and dedication that is required of a model student. And that award goes to Joanna Mazurek. The next two awards will be distributed by Sergeant Tony Medina.
Good morning, everyone. I just wanted to congratulate the class of 2004. Guys. These awards that I'm about to present to the graduating seniors who have earned the highest achievement in mathematics and science awards. The first award is going to be for David Joe Sazer. Not here? Did I say it right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, okay. We'll just put that on. And our second award is going to be to Joanna Souza. Also, I'll be handing out the award for National Scholar and Athlete Award. This certificate is presented to two seniors who have demonstrated academic and athletic excellence. The first award is going to Catherine Shaw.
Our academic decathlon team competes each year in a very rigorous academic competition. We've been doing very well, and that's a tribute to the advisor to that organization, Ms. Barbara Sunday, who will distribute the academic decathlon medal.
Good morning, and I would also like to congratulate the class of 2004. These medals are awarded to those seniors who participated in the state academic decathlon. The recipients are Jesse Campbell, Danielle Agrilo, Andy O'Shea. Patricia Pienkowski. Joanna Schulters. Melanie Sapilnikov.
Next, we have the Berklee College of Business Award. It is presented to a graduating senior in recognition of outstanding perseverance in high school business education, and the recipient is Jessica Koldis. The John Braska Memorial CBE Award is presented by the New Jersey Cooperative Business Education Coordinators Association, and they present the John Braska Memorial CBE Award to the CBE student who demonstrates reliability, classroom attendance, punctuality, attitude, perseverance, and initiative. And that goes to Christoph Haliniak. The Principal's Leadership Award is presented on behalf of Herb Jones. It goes to a student based on demonstrated ability to combine academic excellence and leadership in the school and in the community. And the recipient is Joanna Sluzars. The Prudential Spirit of Community Award is a certificate presented to a student who has demonstrated service to the school and the community, and the recipient is Milena Sopilnikov. A quick mention of what Milena did, or one of the things she did to earn this award. After the unfortunate incident on 9/11, Milena took it upon herself to produce a CD of patriotic-related music, which was then sold and used to raise money for the fund for the people who lost their lives and the families of the people who lost their lives at 9/11 tragedy. So Milena, special recognition for that. The NJSIAA awards are presented to students from each member school who rank in the top 10% of the class and have earned at least 2 varsity letters. This year's recipients are Jack Boskevich and Dominika Boskevich. The NJSIAA also presents a Scholar Athlete Award. It goes to a senior ranked in the top 5% of the class and who has participated in an NJSIAA-sponsored sport and exhibited outstanding school and community citizenship, and that goes to Joanna Sluzars. The Bergen County Scholastic League Sportsmanship Award is given to a male and a female student athlete who have displayed outstanding sportsmanship, presented in recognition of an outstanding high school student, and that goes to Joanna Slizars. The Wendy's High School Heisman Award is presented. It's presented to one boy and one girl in recognition of their academic achievement, athletic accomplishments, and Community Serving County Professional Counselors Association Caring Award. It's presented to a senior who has demonstrated a genuine concern to others through his or her service to school and community, and that also is going to Carlo Villanueva. The next award I'm particularly proud of, I don't know of another school in the county and probably in the state that has a citizenship grade that goes on each student's report card. But the next award is for those students who have attained 100% citizenship throughout their high school career here at Wellington. And in this day and age, that's quite an accomplishment, so I want to really commend them for that before I even read the names. We have a fairly long list, and that's commendable to this class. So I'll go through the list. Here we go. Jesse Campbell. Alicia Lala. Fred Morgan. Pins awarded to graduating seniors who have attained high academic achievement, high scores on national standardized tests, and a grade point average of over 90. Who was selected as the school winner in the National Honor Society Scholarship Program. This was based on his record in the area of scholarship, character, and leadership, and that goes to Edward O'Shea. All right, that concludes the awards part. Is the Hudson United Bank Scholarship. It is for $100. It goes to a student who has achieved academically and who plans to attend a post-secondary school. And the recipient is Angela Carice. The DAR Good Citizenship Scholarship is Mrs. David Van Dillon, the Good Citizenship Chairperson.
This $100 scholarship is awarded to a senior who demonstrates the qualities of ability, service, leadership, and patriotism in the home, school, and community. So, my point, I'm going to mention my name, Christina Dutton.
Representing Mayor Ragacki, Councilwoman Elizabeth Calabrese.
The Wellington High School Memorial Scholarship for $200. This is a scholarship awarded to a graduating senior who has displayed the qualities desired in a Wellington High School student and who plans to attend a post-secondary institute. Our most worthy recipient this year is Sarah Sadecki.
Will be presented by the president of the organization, Ms. Barbara Sunday.
This $200 scholarship presented to a student who has attained high academic standing and will be attending a 2 or 4 year college. This year's recipient is Margaret Malacqua.
Guidance scholarship will be presented by Mrs. Kathleen Cassica, our guidance coordinator, who has done a great job this year filling in for Ms. Jarotsky, who is on maternity leave. So I would like to bring up Mrs. Cassica to give you this award.
This $200 scholarship is presented by the Bergen County Directors of Guidance to a senior who has demonstrated through word and action sincere concern for others throughout her high school career. The award goes to Alicia Lala.
Our arts program last month saw the quality of the work that was produced by our students, and that's a tribute to the art teacher, Ms. Paula Van Markham. But in addition to that, Ms. Van Markham has also taken it upon herself to raise scholarship money in memory of Mr. Greg Nichols, an employee in the district who tragically passed away at a very early age in his life. and she's to be commended for that. So Ms. Paula Van Horn.
This year, the Greg Nichols Scholarship is being awarded to two graduating seniors who I hope will continue their art studies. The first one goes to someone who learned an important...
The Asian Scholarship will be distributed by Athletic Director Mr. James Brannan. Be presented by the advisor, Mr. Craig Patterson.
I'm proud to be here today on behalf of the Wallington High School FBLA. More than 55 years, the FBLA has helped high school students successfully transition from school to careers. The FBLA prides itself on producing students of character, leadership, good citizenship, academic excellence, and school spirit. And it's a pleasure to present this award to the individual who is attaining standards, Jesse Quinlan.
Jesse and Mr. Patterson have also taken the initiative. I really got to give credit to Jesse forming a technology club. And that technology club has been accepting computers, donating computers. They've been refurbishing them and providing them to students in our district who need one at home. And I think that's a quality thing. They have to be commended for that initiative. The Women's Auxiliary of Hose Company number 203 scholarship will be presented by Mrs. Christine Zalewski.
This $200 scholarship is awarded to a child or grandchild of a member of the Ladies Auxiliary or the Wallington Fire Department.
Our softball coach, head softball coach, Mrs. Karen Albanese.
$250 scholarships are sponsored by Charlotte Stetson family. They are awarded to players who are totally dedicated and put the team before themselves.
This will be presented by Mr. Ed Rentio.
Presented to the member of my father, Mr. Ed Rentio. Former teacher and coach and student at Long High School. One of the awards is to a female athlete who's participated in a
school organization. They do a lot of fundraising during the course of the year, and they raise money not only for senior scholarships, but also for every single class account. Money is donated to the classes by the Home and School Organization. I'm very proud to say that today the Home and School will be distributing over $8,000 worth of scholarships to our seniors. And I'd like to bring up a person who did a great job in her term.
These $250 scholarships are awarded by rank to 9 students attending a minimum full-year post-secondary school program. The first award goes to Richard Baer. Jack Duda. Fabiola. Aisha Lala. Kinga Made. Awarded by rank to 15 students who have achieved a high academic average and plan to attend a four-year college. Our first recipient is Melissa Alfano, Holly Blank, Monica Dable, secondary school. These recipients will be selected at this time. Martian Stolka. Lindsay Culhever.
Thomas Scholarship to the graduating senior who has excelled in academics and plans to pursue a career in health service, and that person is Daryl Steinberger.
MTA President, Mrs. Susan Heinrich.
is awarded by the PTA to a student who has attended the public grammar school and high school in Marlton for his or her entire school career and has achieved high academic standing. Edward O'Shea.
Scholarships will be issued by the advisor, Mr. Rudolph Pavlik.
$300 scholarships are awarded to seniors who intend to continue their education at a post-secondary school and who have participated on the Student Council Executive Board. These four young ladies have been the center of the Student Council this year.
Anna and Edward Kelsey Scholarship is awarded to a student who has achieved academic proficiency and plans to attend a post-secondary school to study engineering or mathematics. The award goes to Jack Dula.
Scholarship is awarded to a student who has excelled academically and is planning a career in business. She will be attending to her four-year college. Kinga Marquette.
Presented by John F. Kennedy Memorial Library, is awarded to a senior planning to attend a post-secondary school and who has exhibited appreciation of the function of our library services. And the recipient is Magdalena Lugutko.
First one is to Patricia Piankowski, and next is to Carlo Villanueva Williams.
Academic standing and has participated in the high school athletic program.
Scholarship is presented in memory of my daughter, Deanne Wright, a 1990 graduate. Is awarded to a college-bound female athlete who is a member of the National Honor Society, and I'm proud to give my scholarship to Catherine Shaw.
Wellington Lions Club, I'm proud to present these two $500 scholarships, which are presented to the students who have demonstrated scholastic aptitude, proper citizenship, and leadership qualities. Recipients are Holly Blank and Kevin Picaro.
By the president of the WBA, Mrs.
Our scholarship is presented to a student who plans to enter teaching profession and has
Lola Junior.
Well, on behalf of our administration and faculty, we want to certainly congratulate all of our award and scholarship recipients. Over the last couple of years, since our military has been involved in armed conflict across the world, I've paused at this portion of the ceremony to recognize those that are serving overseas.
It is given in memory of the student class of 1977, and the recipient is Ruthie Nicole.
This $500 scholarship was established by the class of 1985 and is presented each year to a graduating senior who plans to attend a post-secondary school to develop his or her talent and or academic skills. The student will have demonstrated high standards, ideals, and qualities desired in a Wellington High School student and work conscientiously for the betterment of his or her class. This year, the scholarship goes to Monica Abel.
Thanking the whole family for his dedication and passion to our family and the tournament. Okay, these scholarships are presented on behalf of Friends of our committee. They are given to students who have participated in softball and displayed outstanding leadership and sportsmanship. The winner of the $500 scholarship is Joanne Sousar.
$1 scholarship donated by Mr. Joseph Smith, our current Board of Education president, on behalf of his late father, Ed